Hello class 7. In this video I am going to explain the second part of the chapter A New Day from your English Rapid. In last video we saw that when Henchard got his sense, he could understand that what blunder he had done, and he was finding his wife and his daughter, but he lost all his lost all the possibilities, and he was also thinking that why, maybe he was at that time he lost his control, but why his wife did not say anything to him, why did she not stop, not make him stop. Okay, so actually it was a part of his repentance. Henchard was repenting at that time, so he was thinking these things. Okay, so now we are going to start with the second part of the chapter number 2, and please take out the book and turn to page number 11. From the second paragraph we are going to start. Now when Henchard was drastically finding his wife and his daughter at that moment, he just repenting also at that moment, what did he do? About 3 or 4 miles away he saw a village and a church and went towards it. So about 3 or 4 miles he went to a place, and it was looking like a village, and there he saw a church. He went towards the church. He knelt there and took an oath that he would avoid all strong alcohol for the next 21 years, 1 year of penance for each year he had lived. So that means what to say, that at that moment Michael Henchard was 21 years old. So when he went into the church, at that moment he knelt there in front of Almighty, and he wanted to take an oath, wanted to take a promise to himself that he would never ever touch alcohol, because of that alcohol he had lost his wife and his daughter. So he also told to himself, he also promised to himself that he would give up the habit of taking alcohol, and also he would penance. He would also do the penance. That means what is the meaning of penance? Penance means atonement. Okay, when someone is doing a crime, after committing the crime, when the person realizes that he or she had done something wrong, so when he or she wants to get out of that condition, so at that moment he or she should repentance, and they must do something for themselves, and they must what in Bengali it is called prashchitto. So this word penance is also the same meaning. Okay, so he also told to himself that here for his penance, he for his you can say atonement, he just had to leave the habit of taking alcohol. Okay, when he came out he saw a smoking chimney and went to the house requesting to buy some breakfast. So then after taking the oath and after repenting what he had done, then he came out from the place, and then he saw a smoking chimney and went to the house requesting to buy some breakfast. So he saw that a chimney was there, and from that chimney smoke was coming out, and then he went to that house and requesting to buy some breakfast, and then he went to the house and then he wanted to have some breakfast. Okay, then he began looking for his wife and daughter. After having the breakfast, then again he was searching for his wife and his little daughter. He searched for days, but no one had any idea. He had no idea of the sailor's name. So he searched for many days, and the thing is that he just lost his when he sold his wife and his daughter. At that moment, he could not. He forgot the name of the sailor. Okay, he could not recall the name of the sailor. So he did not able to find he was not finding his wife and his daughter. Okay, so he did not have any idea of the name of the sailor to whom he sold his wife and daughter. He could not make much of a hue and cry, since that would reveal his shameful behavior. So he could not make much. What is the meaning of here? He could not make much of a hue and cry. Hue and cry is an idiom. Its meaning is strong protest about something. When we are protesting something, so that is the meaning. Strong protest about something is the meaning of hue and cry. So he could not make much of a hue and cry, since that would reveal his shameful behavior. When it was discovered that Michael Henchard was the one who had committed this crime, so from that moment onwards, he also actually did not get any strong protest. He could not able to protest, he could understand. He was very shameful for his behavior. He was very shameful for his conduct, what he had done. He spent months looking for her, and whenever he could, picked up odd jobs. He spent months, lots of months, he was looking for his wife and his daughter. In this course, he took lots of jobs, and he also lost lots of jobs over there. And he worked for here and there, and he was searching here and there, everywhere, but he all in vain. He did not able to take his wife and his daughter. Now finally his search took him to a seaport. Finally he went to a seaport, that means the port near to a sea. Okay, asking the place, generally the ships from the ships, the place, port is a place from the ships are going into the going for the sail or coming to the port. Okay, when the ships are going into the ocean and the ships are coming back from the ocean, that place is called port. Okay, so at the last he searched at the port. Now asking around, he found that three people similar to those he had looking for had recently left the shores for foreign lands. When he placed to the port, he got the news that two women were there, one woman and one girl child was there, and there was a sailor also, and they were there at the port. And on that moment when Henchard came to that port, before that three of them went to they started their journey for foreign lands. He gave up the search. So Henchard could understand that three people were the same people whom he was trying to find out. And when he realized that, he was so much in he was very morose, and he just gave up his search also. Okay. The next day, traveling southwest, he reached Casterbridge, Wessex, and after that he went to another place after traveling to southwest side, and then he reached a new place, and the place is called Casterbridge of Wessex.